देता हूँ किरण अयूब तनोली एडवोकेट साहिबा को कि वो आए और इन्वेस्टिगेशन रिफॉर्म्स के हवाले से अपने ख्यालात का इजहार करें।
बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। ऑनरेबल प्रेसिडेंट हाई कोर्ट बार एसोसिएशन अब्टाबाद, ऑनरेबल प्रेसिडेंट डिस्ट्रिक्ट बार एसोसिएशन अब्टाबाद एंड मानसेरा अब्टाबाद, सॉरी डिस्ट्रिक्ट मानसेरा, respectable legal fraternity member bar councils, respectable IG police, DIG police, other senior officials of and the district administration respectively, print and electronic media, assalamu alaikum. My topic for today is that police investigation is the turning point in criminal justice system. Mr. President, as we all know that the police are the entry point in the criminal justice system and a door for the access of justice. But if its core function of an investigation is compromised due to the political interference, vested interests, or corruption coupled with inefficiency, it will surely lead to miscarriage of justice at the doorstep. Mr. President, I believe that today in this auspicious seminar, majority of the serving senior police officers as well as other officials would certainly agree that probably there are thousands of innocent individuals, both men and women, young and old, who somehow got implicated in some acts of crimes and have been handed out different sentences, even from death to life imprisonment or other terms, only and only because of flawed investigations. Mr. President, why we always forget, why we don't pay any heed, why we are still ignorant to the fact that investigation is the backbone of every criminal justice system. My learned colleagues, the high standard of proof can only be achieved if evidence is properly collected, secured, and documented at stage of investigation. Mr. President and the worthy guests, I will take your kind attention towards the idea underlying the provisions of Section 169 CRPC. As you all know that, in case of insufficiency of evidence, the police, that is the SHO or the investigation officer, may release person or the accused that he is somehow not connected with the offense or the crime. Mr. President, the legal obligation is to investigate the case independently, honestly, consciously, with all legal parameters, so in order to bring the real culprits before the court of law. And the powers as contemplated in Section 169 CRPC are unfortunately being misused by the concerned police authorities for vested reasons, and accused are getting narrow escape from the clutches of the law. Mr. President, it is not the duty of an investigating officer to only collect evidence, surprisingly, in defense of the accused in order to oblige him for ulterior motives. Moreover, the IO is not supposed to arrogate to himself the function of the adjudication in order to determine nature of offense and then give a pre-trial verdict about the innocence of the accused. This is very much surprising. But unfortunately, Mr. President, this is what is going on. My learned colleagues, this is the high time to hire crime investigation experts who should be trained on scientific lines using latest forensic sciences for collection of evidences to corroborate the facts in any crime. For interrogation purposes, we need to hire psychologists and psychiatrists to engage with alleged criminals instead of using the third degree tactics. My dear colleagues, for many, many years, Pakistan has been affected by instability, political unrest, and acts of terrorism. Rising crime rates, particularly the organized crimes, are adding to the miseries and agonies of the citizens. And on the contrary, our law enforcing officers are still perceived as lacking investigation skills and professionalism because systematic trainings in modern methods and technicalities and techniques of investigations are missing. I would again say that it is high time that investigative function shall be further developed, and only certified investigators must be deputed in this regard. Thank you very much. Thank you.